Yeah, hey, this is GT here with another YouTube video. And today, kind of wanted to go around a few things in general, things that I've been talking about. In particular, what comes to mind and what I seem to be led to be talking about today. And of late, in general, is the system, the beast system of which I, in general, have been speaking of. Like almost everything I do is about the system, the deceptions built into the system. And the methodologies that are being used, and how amazingly fantastical, conspiratorial, crazy they may seem to be. But when you think about it, anything that goes outside of the box that you've been programmed into, you know, if I was a mime, I could do a better box. Maybe it's like this big. It's probably smaller because you're boxed in with your beliefs. You know. Anyway, and I think, you know, when I talk to people, usually mostly family members and stuff, but in general, people probably think I'm just totally insane, you know, certifiable, because I tell them things that, you know, they will brush off that guy's crazy, you know, because, because I'm saying things that they don't understand, and I'm saying things that they can't understand because they haven't sought the truth, you see. When you seek the truth, when you seek the way, then pathways are opened up for you to understand, for you to believe. In your heart and in your mind, there are avenues and gates that are open, you know. And I've led a pretty charmed life, if you could say that. That's probably a misnomer. Probably, you know, a guided or, you know, I don't know. Anyway, let's just say that I came to an understanding about a lot of things that were disturbing to me, and they made me angry as well. You know, that, like, people want to do what? I mean, you know, it's not people, though. It's not. People aren't intentionally trying to poison you. You see what I'm saying? With all this stuff, everything that they do, most of it, they're deceived themselves. The purveyors of the poisons are themselves deceived and deluded into thinking that they are doing good. Or whatever they're doing is you know, beneficial in one way or another. You know, like they'll put a light on, for example, abortion. You know, abortion. Well, you know, you've got this young lady. She's in the prime of her life, and she doesn't have any money, and blah blah blah. You know, you're gonna, you know, break her down the rest of her life with a child. Well, yeah. I mean, that's the biggest blessing that the Father could ever bestow upon any woman, is to have a child. You know, I mean, look at Sarah. You know, she's like, oh, man. And it just breaks their hearts that they can't have a child. And there's so many women now who are sterile, sterilized by the chemicals and environments and the poisons and the radiation and all that. And you know, back when I was growing up, there was no such thing as a fertility clinic. There wasn't any problem with fertility, you know what I'm saying? The males were fertile. In general, the females were fertile. And everything, you know, was moving along. And now, with all these, you know, endocrine disruptors and hormones and all that circulating to from the toilet to tap and all throughout our entire environment, all the plastics, you know, bottled water, you know, who would think, you know. But somebody is in charge of that, okay? Somebody, somewhere down the line, is in charge of maintaining, putting that stuff into your system. And whether or not they know what harm is coming from that, we, you know, it doesn't matter because it's happening, you know. But there is an evil presence, an evil prince of the world, prince of the air, which, you know, is our overlord here. Whether we recognize it, whether we acknowledge it, or whether we believe it, it doesn't matter because it's happening and we are all reaping the benefits and the detriments that are being dished out upon us by our overlord here, you know. And many of us are bowing to the overlord and the beast and worshiping the beast and his system without seeming understanding or seeming knowledge of it. So part of the awakening, you know, with a capital A, awakening is a thing and hopefully a growing and burgeoning thing. The awakening is, part of it is to inform those who don't seem to get it, you know, what it's about. And, you know, once informed, you know, you were told, you just chose not to believe, or you chose not to test things, you know. So, people out there, if you two, you know, if I say to you, you know, cell phones and microwave cell phone frequencies emanating from towers all around you are bad for you, are harmful to your health, and work in conjunction with many other environmental aspects and toxins and nanoparticulates from chemtrails and all such things, with barium and selenium, or what is, no, it's barium and I don't know. Anyway, I've been seeing, as I have continued my research, which is like never ending, I'm always looking for more stuff all the time. And you know, the radical, crazy ideas that I have in my head and that I perhaps haven't put out, you know, in so many words, you know, the even to me seem radical or perhaps a little crazy, But they, these videos and the more information I gather, you know, documentation and people's testimonies and all that, the more I know, the more I know that the things that I have been thinking about, the ideas and the concepts and the understanding to which I have been adding over time, have all come to be proven, more or less. I mean, perhaps not, you know, without any shadow of a doubt, but with reasonable, you know, with reasonable human understanding and examination, I think, you know, most people say, for example, if it went into a court of law, I think that, you know, a panel of peers, given the sufficient understanding and the information that supports various and sundry, you know, ideas and thoughts about reality the way that it really is, it would be borne out and declared, yeah, you're not insane, you're right, you're a free man, yoo-hoo, you know, okay, I'm free. But, yeah, one of those things. I'm kind of racing the clock here, so one of those things is the medical model, you know, and I did at least one video on that, and I mentioned it here and there, you know, throughout. But if you look up the word pharmakia, that's with a K, look it up, Google it or whatever, and there'll be several good references, and I may put them in here, you know, I'm sure I have them bookmarked. Pharmakia is basically mentioned within the scriptures, and that's the Greek word pharmakia. It means sorcery, drugs, witchcraft, whatever, okay, basically. And I tell people, and I told people, and they don't seem to understand, you know, within the context, okay, I don't want to get this mixed up. Okay, the medical model under which we subscribe to it, I don't know. It's seemingly everyone is under the spell of the medical model, of the Western medical model, which is a system of systematic deception and a fleecing of the wool off the sheep, if one understands the concept of sheeple, okay? Sheeple aren't there just to be hanging around. Sheeple are there to be sheared, okay? How do they shear you? Well, let me count the ways. Number one, they work you. You work to make products that they sell back to you. Okay. They profit off every step of the way. Someone else profits off of your work, not you. Then, you know, about half, probably more, of your money that you make as a slave goes to the government straight, the government corporation, the whore, the beast, whatever. It feeds itself through your work. You work hard to give your money to the beast. Do you understand? You give your money to the beast through taxes, fees, licenses, schedules, etc., 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 all mandated by a false system of law which tries to tell you Well, they don't tell you, huh? But you're a corporation. They make you a corporation so that you can be part of the beast and do commerce with the beast. Do you understand? Commerce, look it up in Black's Law Dictionary. And I did a video of this previously having to do with fornication. Okay. Fornication is commerce. Do you understand? What does the whore and the harlot do? She fornicates with all the nations of the earth, all the kingdoms of the earth. Okay? And the kingdoms are corporations, basically. Do you get it? It's a whole system of law and understand. It's a whole different reality than the reality that you think that it is. Okay? And most people think, and it's hard for me to get my head around it many times, but this is the way the system works. Okay? So you're a slave. And so, in general, the beast system is there to fleece you, and someone or some things, corporations, and then that trickles into the supposed corporation's owners. Anyway, I don't want to go all into that, but it's all about money. You know. Ching. It's all about money. The love of money is the root of all evil. And most of all evil, really, has some monetary gain for some evil person or persons somewhere along the line. And that seems to be the motivation for all the vice and the evil and the crime and the just general bad things that happen to people is because of wanting to fleece the sheep, okay? And part of that fleecing is also intentionally, whether or not any of the purveyors know it, intentionally poisoning and intoxicating and altering and changing the temples of the children of our Father Almighty so that they become ill and have diseases and pestilences and all such things. Now that sounds ridiculous, you know. We've got this giant medical establishment and it takes care of us. Right? We've got a drug for everything, every symptom, every whatever, but where's the cures? Have you ever thought about that? Do you know anybody who's really in really good health? I mean, I don't, personally. I don't think. Maybe you do. I don't know. But if they are, then they're probably awakened to the fact of the system, and they understand that they have to ingest good food, real food, not this food-like product stuff that they got in the grocery store. Okay? That's all part of the system. They get you into the system. The system is that they give you, they sell you a bill of false and bad goods. They call it food, for example. Food. You consume it or you use it or whatever. It makes you ill, okay, or promotes disease or kills good things in your system or alters you or you know, gives you a deficit or some, you know, malfeasance of some kind, and you become ill, okay? Then you go to the into the medical system, okay? And this is why every you know, totalitarian system has a clamp on the medical system, because if you have a clamp and control over the whole medical system, like in communist countries of old and whatever, then you can hold things over on people, even, you know, like, well, you know, we see on your chart here that you've got such and such disease and whatever, but we can't treat you because, you know, you're not supporting the state-sponsored ideas, and, you know, you're kind of a, what we would call a rebel, or a persona non grata. So, you know, we're not going to treat you or give you any treatment. Okay, so there's a point of control. There's many more points of control. You know, people are afraid when they're sick, and they're afraid to die and all that. But, okay, so you go into the medical system, and you see a doctor, and you've got doctors and nurses and the whole system, and they perform a bunch of tests, and they, you know, each one of those tests just, you know, cha-cha-ching, somebody's paying for that, yeah. And if you've got insurance systems that make you think that you're not paying, well, I don't really mind, you know, going to the doctor and paying it, you know, a copay, because I'm not really paying for it. And then, but you're not understanding that you're paying big money to have that insurance. I mean, big money. And the biggest money of it is now that the government's gotten involved and mandated that you have to have it. So there's another tax. Hey, even the Supreme Court said it was a tax. Do you understand the fleecing of the sheep? Fleecing of the sheep. You know, they're chopping that stuff off left and right off of, you know, the average American worker is paying a bunch of money. And not only for taxes now, but also for insurance. So how much of your, which is really a tax, okay? Obamacare was declared to be another tax by the Supreme Court of the United States, not the United States of America, but the United States. Okay, understand the difference. There's a big difference between those two entities or concepts. Okay, and if you don't understand that, then you need to look it up. All right, anyway, so they got you into the medical system, which is a tax. Okay, the whole insurance scam. Metascam, Obama scam, whatever, Obama care less. So that's another fleecing, fleecing, they're fleecing you for that tax every day. See, when you're young and you're not not really getting sick and all that, you're paying into their big time, okay? The more money you make, I imagine the more money you have to pay, because it's a percentage or something. I don't know what it is, because I'm not in the system. Anyway, so they're fleecing you then. Then you go into this medical system, you see a doctor, okay, you see a doctor, you pay big money for see the doctor, you pay big money for all his tests, which are of, you know, don't treat you, don't help you whatsoever. They just soak you for more and more taxes, more or less, because you're alive and you're in the system. So, you know, they have to fleece you as much as possible. Okay, so then inevitably, I mean, the doctor isn't going to say, he's not even going to ask you, you know, what anything about your lifestyle, anything you do, what you eat, or anything, you know. He's not going to ask you, he's not going to tell you anything about that, he's not going to, you know. He might just, oh, you know, you're eating right? Yeah. Okay, whatever. I don't want to go into that too much. But inevitably, you'll be written out, you know, a series of freaking, prescriptions for a bunch of chemicals that you are supposed to ingest, okay? Now, we call this medicine, but it's pharmakia, okay? And what I began to say in the beginning of this, having to do with pharmakia, is a form of sorcery or witchcraft. And up until recent 20th century thinking, or 21st and 20th century, but there used to be a system of homeopathy and herbal remedies and all that, and people who gave holistic and thoughtful plant-based remedies and stuff that have been handed down and known about for thousands of years and all that, you know. And somehow or another, you know, these like ancient peoples and stuff, they had stuff that did like the Chinese and you know, the Samaritans and the Mayans and all, every, you know, culture had a knowledge of pharmakia, which is basically healing arts and all that. But they used, in the model, the medical model of today, big pharma and big med and big chem combined into a like three strikes and you're out kind of a thing, in which they prescribe you basically what are allopathic toxic poisonous compounds, which may or may not hide the symptom, but they're purported to. So the placebo effect may be actually most of what actually occurs, or a belief that they will occur may be stronger. The belief that the medicines, the so-called medicines that you and I have been prescribed, at least me in the past, the belief, the simple belief that they would do something for you, may have done more than the actual drug.